Hey everybody, and welcome back to my Fallout 3 BB gun run. After the crash at the end of the last episode, all I had to do was go back and get some BBs from Chief Gustavo. Luckily this time around, I actually got almost 400 BBs instead of just 100. So, for fairness sakes, we're going to do the exact same thing we did last time, which is quick travel to the Super Duper Mart. Which, if... like last time, we might end up in a pack of raiders. Yep, there they are. So we're going to crouch and then start shooting these guys because fair's fair. So we're going to pop some medics so we don't get ourselves killed. Medics, yeah. And then we are going to read that tumblers today. We're going to fight to the death with this group of raiders. First, we're going to try to get some cover. Why? Why do you keep coming after me with your fists, moron? Crippled his head. But we aren't in cover because we're obviously taking some gunshots from across the way. This guy just has a nail board, but still, we're going to try to cripple his arm, see if we can get him to drop it. Unlike last time, we actually have some decent armor this time, which is pretty good. Pump some shots into him. Seems like one of those guys over there has an assault rifle. I'm not looking forward. Aha! We got him to drop his nail board somewhere with a critical hit, so that's good. So, let's see. This guy has a 32. That guy has a 10. And bats won't let us see the other guy. So we're going to start by taking a couple shots at this guy. 10 millimeters worse than a 32. Has a higher DPS because we can put out more shots per round. Doing okay. Glad we got some more BBs this time around because it would suck actually to have to do this combat and run out of BBs at the same time. Move back behind this building, do some healing. So we're going to float fly me. Save the blood packs, they can be useful later on. Same with the Nuka-Cola. Like, we'll drink the Nuka-Cola if we have to, but right now we're just going to save it. There you are. That was unpleasant. Aha! We hit him. We only had a 48% chance, but that's still pretty good for hitting that raider. Crouch will actually... No. Die. You're gonna die. Crippled his head, which is gonna keep him from attacking around. The other guy has a... hunting rifle, which is bad. That does more damage than 32. Yeah, you run. And it looks like the other guy's taking off running, so we're going to hunt him down. Actually, we'll just let him go. You know, I say live and let live. If he doesn't come after us, we're just going to let him be off over there scared somewhere. Take the ammo off these guys and any weapons they have that are worth or anything. So yeah, one of these guys did have an assault rifle, but again, they just disappeared and I don't know where they went. So... weird. So today we're heading towards the Anchorage War Memorial to finish the Wasteland Survival Guide quest. Well, not finish a part of the Wasteland Survival Guide. There's still actually one more part we have to do in this chapter, and then there's another chapter consisting of three parts. Yeah, so we're just going to follow a road over here. It's fairly safe, depending on certain things. There's a rad scorpion and a dead body back there. Since we don't have to, we're not going to fight it. No reason to. I think that's a random encounter that loaded back there where you'd find a dead wastelander with a rad scorpion. But yeah, we're just going to ignore that and walk away. When you're using a BB gun, if you can avoid a fight, why as well? Here's Grandma Sparkle. Grandma Sparkle's pretty cool. Hi, Grandma Sparkle.
Well, look at this. We got us a wanderer all the way out here in Wilhelm's Wharf. You must got some important business out here to be wandering around. But tain't none of my beeswax what you're doing. But if you're interested in trading, maybe we can help each other.
Sure. What are you doing all the way out here?
My boys are hunting lurks. Finest meat you could get, but he don't move around in your stomach like Mole Rat does. Right dangerous, those things. Just as soon take your head off as look at you. Watch yourself out here. They're all over. Nope. Can't say that I heard anything but them works in quite some time.
I'm interested in trading.
We always need bullets. Takes damn near 100 of them to kill a guai.
Yeah, but not really. For me, it might actually take 100 to kill a guai. But we're going to sell her that 10mm pistol we picked up and some of the ammo. Basically wipe her out for caps. There we go. Bye.
You watch out for guai. They're all over.
No, they aren't, Grandma Sparkle. There are no yao guai in this section of the map. But, okay. Bye. So here's a nice little sign pointing us in the direction of the Anchorage War Memorial. The Anchorage War Memorial is full of mire lurks. We are not going that way. There's also a bunch of landmines right here. So if you ever need landmines, that's a good place to pick them up. So, you could walk up to the Anchorage War Memorial, fight all the Mire Lurks, fight your way down through the underbelly of the War Memorial. Just a scavenger. I saw a guy with his gun out and I was wondering what was going on. Let's see if he's got any BBs.
What do you need?
No BBs. So, as I was saying, you could either fight your way through the War Memorial without killing a single Mire Lurk, because that's the optional quest, or we'll put on that environment suit Moira gave us from the last part and dive into the water. We're not taking... We should probably pop some Rad-X, too, to make sure we aren't taking lots of rads while we're underwater. And we'll swim over to the memorial right here. And then right around this section, somewhere, can't remember exactly. Here we go. So it's actually more on the side of the memorial. Yeah, it's right here. If you head down here, there's a sewer grate to the memorial faculty offices. So what we're going to do is we're going to move on in, swim up. We're going to swim over this way. We're going to run out of oxygen and start drowning. Okay. And we're going to crouch. Put on that our combat armor. We're slowly gonna make our way up this way. What's gonna happen is eventually we're gonna come across a Mirelord King. Super fun. We don't want to fight this thing. What we can do is if you activate the quest for Moira. So in this cave is the spawning pod, and if he sees us, we're just going to take off running and find this pod and place the thing in it and then run out. We're not going to kill him. Yep, there you go. He sees us. So, I can't remember exactly where the spawning pod is, so we're going to have to look around. Oh, it's right there. So, hide the observation dice and then take off running this way. And then we're just going to go back underwater. No creatures can hurt you if you're actually totally underwater, because creatures can't attack underwater. And we pop right out. And so the quest was easy as that. You can go up to the memorial and fight your way all the way down to the bottom, which fails the optional side quest. Or you can sneak your way down with, like, a stealth boy or the Chinese stealth suit, or you can just go in the bottom. So, coward's way out is the easiest way out. There's a sleeping bed over here, if you need one to heal up, and a footlocker, that's that dude's, some mentats, don't steal those. We're going to sleep for an hour. Not 7 hours, just to get rid of some of that stuff, and we'll head back to Moira.
looking for the mayor or the sheriff?
You want something?
No, I don't want anything. And there you go. Fairly easy. Guy done no problem. Those Myrlar Kings can do quite a bit of damage, though, so if I had gotten hit, I might have been in trouble, but I didn't, so...
Oh, are they intelligent? Do they have a leader? Some sort of king? Or priests? Or some sort of scaly community center?
I slept the observer in with the eggs, and they're none the wiser.
I'll bet most people would have just gone in there, guns blazing without half a thought. But not you. You're the best research assistant ever. I've been getting a good signal, but what do you think about them from your first-hand observations of them?
They got a little bubbling castle, and they spend all day circling it.
Really? Are you kidding me? No, really, are you? Huh? Guess I'll have to wait and see what I get from the observer. Some of these observations about their armor and camouflage gave me an idea for reinforced, neutral-colored headgear. Here, consider it thanks for not interfering with them. Oh, speaking of which, take these, so you can continue to avoid them in the future.
So, she gives us two stealth boys, which are actually really useful, and the shady hat, which is good, too. The last task for this chapter is something about mole rats, right?
Mole rats can burrow into almost anything and cause a lot of trouble. So I figured I'd make a chemical repellent stick for people to shoo them off. But I need it to be tested before I put the recipe to paper in the guide. So I need you to find some mole rats and test it out a bit.
I'll test out the repellent for you.
It'll be easy. One tap with the applicator and it overwhelms their senses with a sort of feel-bad sensation. Then they're gone before you know it. You could test it out on just a few mole ratties. But for real testing, try it on 10 or more. There should be plenty in the tepid sewers downtown.
Thanks, Moira.
Come back soon.
So the other thing we got for finishing that quest is the shady hat, which makes me feel dumb for not remembering that and buying a hat when we were in Tenpenny Tower. But it's one of the better hats in the game. Sneak plus one and perception plus one. Or sneak plus five, perception plus one. So now we're going to have to go over something a little... some people might be a little miffed about. Yes, this is a Fallout run where I only use the BB gun. But technically, if you look at the weapon that Moira gave us, it's a stick that does 1 point of damage. So, yeah, if you want to get super butt hurt to finish this quest... Oh, Raiders. Well, that went well. Thanks, guys. That's Crazy Wolfgang. He doesn't have anything normally, but junk. He proudly proclaims it. But anyways, back to the subject at hand. Repellent stick. Not a BB gun. Does damage. Some of you are going to say, I am cheating by using this stick to kill these Myrlurks. Well, it's for a quest, so I don't personally consider it cheating because I'm not using the BB gun, and that's all that really matters. Also, we're only going to hit each Myrlurk mole rat once, because after you hit them, you can run away from them a little bit, and they explode, which is really nice. But yeah, so... there's a couple mole rats up here into the back here normally, and then we're going to head over to the location that Moira suggested and kill some of the mole rats there. Yeah, there's another one. Come here, buddy. It actually, and I tell you the truth, I was super conflicted for a long time whether or not I would do this quest. Because, yes, I'm not using a BB gun and these things are dying. But there's two reasons that I feel okay with it. The first is, this is not a weapon. This is an applicator. Moira even said so. The second being is, it's not like I'm using, like, it's a quest that gives me a sniper rifle and tells me to snipe people. I have to use this to finish the quest. quest. And if there was a quest in the game that gave you a sniper rifle and told you to go kill people with it, I wouldn't do that quest. But since this does even more less damage than the BB gun, I don't really feel bad about it. Okay, so we've hit level 4. And let's see. One of the things we have to do right now, which some people might be slightly confused about, is we have to push our science skill up. We're going to push it up to 25. The rest of our points are going to go into small guns, just like normal. Reason we have to push science up to 25 is because we want to take the perk entomologist, and you need science 40. We can't reach that one level, so we're just going to raise it to 25 this level, and next level we're going to raise it to 40. The other thing we're going to take this level is what pretty much everyone takes at this level, which is educated. Every time you level up, you get 2 extra skill points, or 3 extra skill points, so that's really good. So that's going to give us 18 skill points per level instead of 15. Here's another warrant. Whack with stick. Die, Morat. And he explodes. So that's pretty much all the Morats you can easily find around Megaton. So we're going to head over to the Old Olney Sewers. Or the Tepid Sewers, not the Old Olney Sewers. That's a different place. To grab us some more Morat kills. We're going to fast travel to a Williams Wharf, which should be safe enough. Yeah, there's just what looks like... You weren't wearing that hat last time, Grandma Sparkle. Grandma Sparkle wearing a hat. And just jump in the river and swim across. We could disarm these landmines, but I might want these landmines at some point to lead an enemy back into. So, yeah. We're just going to swim across to the Anchorage War Memorial. This is also another random location spawn, so... We're going to have to be careful when we get over there. It could be just friendlies or unfriendlies. Could be everything from a crippled deathclaw to, you know, just vicious dogs. So, let's see what's up on top today. Discover the Anchorage War Memorial. You do have to be careful around here because Grandma Sparkle is right. There is... Mire lurks that you have to be aware of. Looks like there's a wasteland junkie we can talk to. Hi, wasteland junkie.
Hey, man. You need something? A little fix, maybe? Some jet? I got jet. Psycho, too. Take a look.
I'd be more than happy to.
Sure thing, man. Sure thing.
He said he had Psycho. The liar. You are the worst dealer. Don't tell me if you have Psycho if you don't have Psycho. So there's the Anchorage War Memorial. Pretty cool. Yeah. It's got dude standing up there. Guy with a flamer. And dude with a... Gauss rifle? No, that's a rocket launcher. Yeah. So the Tepid Sewers are right over there. But we, again... Mire looks, so be careful as you make your way down here. They do spawn right over there, always. You can see those eggs right there. So yeah, you gotta watch out over there, but looks like we're safe this time around. Found the Tepid Sewers, we're gonna head in and just pop some more rats with a stick. This place does mostly just have mole rats, but you also have to watch out. There's a couple automated turrets that you have to be aware of. Come here, buddy. You too. And then we run away while we wait for them to explode. Did I not? Nope, I hit them both. There we go. My foxes. Always want to take more money. It doesn't sell for a lot, but it also weighs nothing. Same with, like, pencils and darts and... Well, darts are ammunition, but any ammo you find. Yeah. There's a door over here. Hi, buddy. Gonna run away from you. No. Oh, yeah. We want to take scrap metal for a quest back in Megaton. How many rats have we killed so far? Seven more. We have to hit seven more roll rats. So here's the turret control system I was talking about. Yeah, that will definitely shoot us. Sadly, we don't have a high enough science to hack the system, so we're just going to sneak up here and go around. Both those way too much for their cost. And then we're just going to shoot across. Yeah, see, that's one of the problems. The turret will shoot a lot of the Mornats you want to fight. But hopefully we'll be able to finish this quest off without having to go somewhere else to find more rats. Dead Raider. Got some stuff worth taking. Dead Morat. Yeah, if you head down that hallway, there's some... That's where the turret system is. That right there. So yeah, you gotta be careful about that. And then there's a door over here. If you listen carefully, you can hear Morats behind the door. Hi, Morat. Two. Three. Alright, it seems like we have finished the quest. So, now that the quest is finished, we're gonna go back to the BB gun. Because I have no reason to use the stick anymore. Luckily, Morats is one of the few things that we can actually easily take out with a BB gun, so that's pretty cool. And we can just head back this way. Eat some food, because we did get hurt. And since we're out of food, I'm going to pop a stim pack. So, for the life of me, I actually can't remember what's behind that door. So we're going to run over it to it while under turret fire and try to figure it out. Dead Morats, it looks like. And a door over here that... Oh, it leads into the underground. We don't want to go that way. There can be super mutants there, and ghouls, and yeah, I don't want to fight those guys. So we're just going to run our way back up here, and then make our way down. Run back this way. We could have shot the turret system, but I think there's a high likelihood that we would have died before we managed to kill it with a BB gun. So yeah, we're just going to avoid it for now. And we'll fast travel back to Moira. So, yes, we should have done the quest and the optional. The thing is that while you can choose not to do...
Tamper with that, and we're going to have a problem.
Sorry, Walter. Huh, Walter, while you're here.
What do you need?
What do you need? What can I do to help around here?
Well, it's no secret that the old water treatment plant is on its last legs. And I'm the only one in town that can keep the damn thing running. I spend so much time up in the plant that I can't take care of the leaks that keep springing up in the pipes around town. Now, I don't expect much from strangers, but if you've got the know-how, I need someone to hunt down and repair those leaks.
Got it.
I hope you can help. If folks knew how bad it was getting up here, well, I don't know what would happen. Well, back to work.
Thanks, Walter. So, yeah, so there's a couple leaks around town that we can fix real quick here for some XP. And, well, the real benefit is once you do that, you have the ability to trade scrap metal to Walter for caps. So here's the first leak right here. The pipe appears to be damaged, but the source of the leak is an immediate clear. It takes a master plumber to fix it. Repair of 30 or higher. So all we gotta do to get up to a repair of 30 is pop on our vault utility jumpsuit. That puts us as a repair of 22. Luckily, we have Mentats. Mentats raise your perception and intelligence by 5. So it'll give you 2 skill points per skill point it raises you by. So my perception right now is 6. If I take this, it's going to raise it by 8 to a total of 32. Well, it's not 6 because of the hat I'm wearing, but yeah. So repair the pipe. So the first pipe's really easy to find. It's right there. Next one's right over here, which isn't too hard to find. Just got to run up here underneath this moving thing. Fixed it. The last one's actually a little bit harder to find. What I normally do is I run up around here behind Moriarty's Saloon. And make your way over here. And the last leaking pipe is actually right there. You can see it. It's not on any walkway or even on the ground. So the best way to get to it is to make your way right over here to the Creator Side Supply and hop over the railing. And go ahead and fix the pipe. There we go. That's one really easy quest done. Then you can just drop right off here onto this rampway and you won't hurt yourself. If you drop off like over here, sometimes you can break your legs, so I wouldn't suggest it. So yeah, all we gotta do is turn that into Stanley. Or Walter, not Stanley. Stanley's a different game. Yeah. Walter ran away, so we're just gonna wait till morning to speak to Moira. Stanley's the mechanic in the vault, not the mechanic out here, yeah. Hi, Maggie. You're weird. Moira.
Oh, I can't wait to hear how the repellent's working.
I tested out the mole rat repellent extensively.
Oh, excellent. Substantial field testing, precise reports, and such dedication. What more could I ask for in a research assistant? So, how did my chemical repellent work? Safe and clean like a charm, I'll bet.
And I gotta be honest, one of the reasons that I did this quest is this is one of my favorite lines from Moira in the entire game. It's like explosive whack-a-mole. Can I get that in bullet form for people?
That's horrible. You're horrible. Oh, this thing is horrible. Everything's horrible. Oh. With that much testing, I guess it's beyond correction. Go ahead and keep it. Maybe you can find a nicer use for it, but I doubt it. Oh, but for your trouble, here, have the leftover chems from working on the repellent. I'm sure you can find some use for them.
So she gives us 2 jets and 2 psychos. Awesome. I like psycho.
Oh, you. Of course we are. And I think I'm really capturing that snide wit of yours. So for all your snippiness, I think it'll help with the book. Still, I can put up with plenty of your little jabs, as long as the research is good. And yes, you'll still get paid. Here, nothing says loving like big boxes of ammunition, right? Now, on to the next chapter?
I don't know, is it BBs? Nope, then that doesn't help. Okay, last chapter.
The last chapter is a bit more esoteric. It's about the survival of humanity as a whole, and how to rebuild society. Deep stuff, huh? We need to know how large settlements are formed, how to harness the old technology, and I'll need you to get ancient history from a nearby library. We're in the last stretch now, so let's finish it up strong. What's first?
Researching local history sounds easy.
Don't be so sure. You'd be surprised how confused people get. Even about important things. In this case, I'm talking about Rivet City. It's the most successful survivor settlement around, but no one here really knows how it started. Of course, that's why it's important to know how a place like that succeeded. So I need you to go there and do some researching.
Okay. What's Rivet City?
Oh, it's this huge city on a ship where the river meets downtown. It's been around for as long as I can remember. You should really check it out.
Okay, sounds reasonable. I'll research Rivet City history.
Oh, now I can't wait for what you find out down there. And check around to make sure you're hearing the real deal.
Alright, thanks, Moira. Let's see what you have for sale.
Absolutely.
So she has some caps, but no BBs, and no Seiko. So we're just going to sell her some stuff. She knows this 10mm pistol. We're going to sell the repellent stick back to her because we're never going to use it from this point on. She can have our pre-war hat now that we have the shady hat. Get rid of the blaster master helmet. Don't need that right now. Actually, we want to keep that just in case. Sell her some pre-war money. And basically just sell her the ammunition she just gave us back to her. Thanks for all your help. That was really useful. No, I don't want to sell that much. That's too much. There we go.
Good
Wipe her out of caps.
Try not to die.
Thanks, Moira. So, yeah, let's go dump off the scrap metal we have. We'll go find Walter and finish off the unmarked quest where we just fixed the pipes. Hey, Walter.
What is it?
I fixed the pipes.
Well, I'll be. The pressure's up in the plant. It looks like all the leaks have been fixed. Thank you, stranger. Thank you. But listen, it's only a matter of time before they burst again. And someone like you might not be around to fix them. I'll make you a deal. I'll give you caps for any scrap metal you can bring me. You'll find it all over the place out there in the waste. If I have a steady supply of scrap, I can keep the plant running and the pipe should be just fine. We got a deal?
Yeah, Walter, we got a deal.
Good. This just keeps looking better. Those parts will keep this place running and the town in fresh water. Hurry back as soon as you find some.
Hey, Walter, I found some.
What do you need?
Interested in buying some scrap metal?
I sure am, Sonny. What have you got for me?
Just take all the scrap metal I have. You can give it to him for no charge, which will give you positive karma, but I'm trying to keep my karma as neutral as possible because I don't want... If you get bad karma, or good karma, Talon Raiders start hunting you down. If you get bad karma, Regulators start hunting you down, and I don't want either of them. The main benefit to that, by the way, is not the 10 caps he gives you per scrap metal. It's the fact that he gives you 5 XP, which doesn't seem like a lot, but because we're avoiding as much combat as we can, pretty much, we want to get as much XP as possible. So we're going to fast travel to Tepid Sewers, or Anchorage War Memorial. Let's see what's going on there today. Again, this is actually a bad idea. We might flash travel into a random encounter, but looks like it's just a wasteland junkie.
Hey man.
Do you have any Psycho now? No, you still don't have Psycho.
Bye.
So, we're heading to Rivet City, which is down in that direction. There's lots of different ways to get there. By the way, this is the door you would go in if you... One of the doors you can go in to do the... Myler quest. They'll actually let you bypass a couple of the Myler's, which is pretty cool. So basically, on that side we have raiders and super mutants, especially under that bridge there's some raiders. On this side we have super mutants. So the best way to get to Rivet City, if you're trying to not get killed at low levels, is go ahead and put on our environment suit for some radiation resistance, pop some Rad-X. And we're just going to swim. We're going to take some rads as we swim, but it's okay. Fallout 3 rads aren't the horrific thing they are in Fallout 4. Over there on the left-hand side, you can see Duvac's place. There's a quest there. There's the Washington Monument. We're gonna have to go there at some point to put up the dish for the radio. Yeah, see those holes right there? There's actually raiders living in there. Sometimes one of them can have a rocket launcher, so that's no good. Nice bridge. Over there's the Citadel, where the Brother of Steel hang out. Pretty cool. You can only access it through the main quest, so it's not even worth heading over there right now. Right over here normally spawns like a super a higher level tier super mutant than you would normally see. A couple normal super mutants, and then like right now it would be a super mutant master. So yeah, with a minigun. So don't want to go that direction. Still, yeah, that's the backside of the Citadel. And they'll be fighting, sniping some super mutants over in that direction. Right there's the Jefferson Memorial, where the main quest takes you. While we're on the subject of the main quest, I haven't done any of the main quest bits yet, and one thing I will not be doing is sequence breaking. I will be playing, you can actually sequence break the quest and skip a good half of the first quest. I will not be doing that. I will be doing the entire main storyline, just for fairness sake. There's Rivet City. That's where we want to go. We do not want to go to the War Memorial because currently there's a bunch of super mutants right there. And I want to have some more perks and stuff before I start trying to take on a group of super mutants. Like, maybe one or two, we might be able to fight them. I don't know. I've never tried. But there's quite a few there, and depending on their level, we could get in a bunch of trouble. So we're just going to carefully swim this way. Some people would point out that this is actually the first thing you should do in the game. Swim down the river like this and head to the... Oh, something's shooting at us. Yeah, there's that super mutant right there. We're just gonna run. Gonna put on some actual armor and run like nobody's business. Oh, and there's another, well, I guess it's not overlords and levels, it's brutes. There's another brute. He's going to shoot at us, but he's not going to come down from his little encampment, so we should be fine. We're just going to make... I made a weird noise. I thought it was like a dog was attacking me, but apparently it was my character. So we're going to head, and as you can see right here, Rivet City. Most people run right to Rivet City right away, because that way they can actually pick up the intelligence bobble to head to get one extra skill point per level. I've never really liked doing that. If I'm playing a build that like you get plenty of skill points in Fallout 3, and if you're playing a build that actually needs 10 intelligence, you might as well just put 10 intelligence at level 1.
Don't even think about it.
But I'm not a huge optimizer, so.
The wasteland. Welcome to my humble caravan. Please relax, for we are in a place of safety.
Thanks, Lucky.
The type of safety that can only be ensured by an abundance of weaponry, both wicked and awesome, all of which can be yours for the right price.
So, this is Lucky Harith. He's one of the traveling caravans. He sells ammo and weapons, so he might have some BBs. Help from the mayor of... Oh, and sorry about that.
See, the world's a dangerous and unbalanced place. So I realized the only way to bring peace was to make sure that everyone could be dangerous. So, with a little bit of help from the mayor of Canterbury Commons, I set up this caravan. I can't give the weapons away for free, but I come close.
I'm here to buy.
Please, enjoy my...
So, yeah, he doesn't have any BBs. He does sometimes, but he does have the schematics for the shish kebab. If we... That's one of the... best melee weapons in the game. And, well, we had another crash to desktop, so we're going to call it apart here. Next time, we'll head into the Rivet City to do the Wasteland Survival Guide quest. So thank you very much for joining me on my Fallout 3 BB gun run.